It's really the prime members, the new ones that sign up because of this day that most investors are focused on. So what are you expecting there?
Well, what we expect is that certainly there will be some growth, but the truth is from some of the data that Forrester's collected from consumers, about 60% of people didn't even shop on Prime Day. And of the rest that did, you had about half actually purchasing something. Now, when you end up having a 50% conversion rate, that is much, much higher than your average day in e-commerce. And some of those consumers are going to be new, although the vast majority will be existing Amazon shoppers. But what the onus is on Amazon to provide compelling deals. And the big theme that we've seen is that they've offered more appliances, more electronics, higher ticket items like the Instant Pot and their own devices to try to drive up sales.
Yeah, I mean, that really would boost the GMV numbers, Tom, that could be had out of this holiday. What's your outlook, though, in terms of providing these deals and having consumers actually shop for the entire amount of time? I mean, Prime Day was a day once upon a time, and then it became Prime 36 hours, and now it's Prime 48 hours. I mean, can we extrapolate the pace of sales on a one-day or 36-hour basis to 48 hours?
So basically, if you think about Prime Day, it's a dress rehearsal for Black Friday, Cyber Monday. So it basically stress tests the Amazon system, including logistics. And if you think about last year, at the beginning of Prime Day, you saw more pictures of the dogs of Amazon than you saw products to purchase. And I do think that that was one contributing factor to why Prime Day is 48 hours this year instead of 36 hours last year. To Sukarita's point, though, I think the big delta this year is they now have one-day shipping for Prime members. So to the extent that now you have their big sale for Prime Day, but you're getting product to consumers faster, that could be another catalyst for an increase in membership for Prime.
So, Tom, let's say we get the numbers out from Amazon, you know, the day after or so, Prime Day. What numbers are you looking for? What are you expecting?
Well, the other challenge for Amazon in 2019 is that they're experiencing decelerating growth in their U.S. sales. So hopefully the combination of shifting to one-day Prime from two and now a very successful Prime Day will result in a reacceleration in unit growth in both the June quarter on the move to one day and the September quarter on a successful Prime Day.
Sukarita, is the one-day shipping going to make a huge difference this time around? Could we actually see a higher volume of sales?
Well, as Tom said, I think that the accelerated shipping really is about stress testing. They know that for the last several years, there have been challenges with Q4 shipments. And there are very low stakes with getting the shipments to customers within a day. If they get it wrong, it's not a big deal. It's not as if somebody is going to, kind of be all up in arms and probably churn away from Amazon the way that a Q4 misshipment can have that negative effect because people are expecting orders at a specific time. So for them to be able to deliver the volume of transactions, it will likely be hundreds of millions in a short compressed period of time, and to push all of their distribution centers to be able to execute this as effectively as they need to. This really is about giving them basically practice for doing this later in the year, day after day in Q4.
And Tom, in terms of earnings, we're expecting them, they're just around the corner. So what are you looking for, and how does Prime Day help Amazon? I mean, how much does, you know, can Amazon, you know, change its quarter or its guidance based on this?
So it definitely can be a needle mover because it can be the biggest one-day sale, or in this case, two-day sale, like a Black Friday, like a Cyber Monday. But really, the story for Amazon on earnings has been their three big profit drivers, cloud computing, AWS, third-party retail, with now more than 50% of units sold being third-party, and advertising. And I do think that Prime Day can be a stimulant on the advertising front to the extent that you're motivating brands to do more advertising on Amazon to stick out from the crowd. What we didn't see last year that we're looking for this year is more promotion of their private label efforts, especially in men's apparel, because that also could then be an incremental margin driver for Amazon and therefore favorable to profits.